Hi guys, this is Prios and yeah, welcome to another study stream. Yeah, let's right jump into the first hand. That's the one you can see on the screen. I wonder if that's an open race. My guess would be no, but let's find out. It's definitely a close one. Well, I guess with all these very small cards, it might be a fold. Raising, yeah, okay, I was wrong. It's an raise. And yeah, I guess if it's getting raised and re-raised, we obviously have to stay in. So first one already finished. Yeah, this one, I can tell you, so tilted when this happened. The action went like this. I 3-bet preflop, he calls. On the flop, I check behind. On the turn, I make trip sixes, but I would still be behind against an eight. I could already shove the turn because he might be bluffing with open enders, and we don't necessarily want them to give a free card. But anyways, I decided to just call. And yeah, on the river is another eight, giving me the second nuts, and he shoves into me. And yeah, I was very annoyed about this, and yeah, thought that this must be an eight for sure. But given the way I played the hand by checking back the flop, showing weakness, and just calling the turn, I thought that I could not fold. And there's also a slight possibility that he might be overvaluing a hand like queens or kings, which he now is shoving for value. So I made the crying call. And surprisingly got the good news. He had pocket queens and for some reason thought that he has to value shove the river. So I scooped a nice little pot here. What do you think? Is this, in your experience, an eight most of the time, or are people spewing or even bluffing? I mean, it's like suicidal. My hand looks exactly like what it is, checking back the flop and calling the turn. I mean, he has to give me aces a lot here, and he still was shoving the river like it was nothing. And I was like, what is going on? But yeah, luckily he was stupid enough to shove queens for value. Next one. Ah, yeah, that's a tough one too. I 3-bet pre, he calls. This guy is a very loose and aggressive player. On the flop, I conti bet small, he raises small, I call. And yeah, on the turn, it felt like there's nowhere out for me anymore. And yeah, it feels very bad to now call. And yeah, but let's see what the solver thinks about this situation. Call, our flop is Jack 7-7 with a possible flush draw. Jack 8-8. Me. Ach, we don't have a board close to that one, I guess. Which one do we take instead? I guess Jack 8-8 we use instead. And yeah, let's download the sim and see how. What we are supposed to do with ace, ace, jack, seven. We need to Or ace, ace, jack, nine. Jack, seven, jack, nine. Let's make it jack, nine. So, yeah, we have to edit our hand a bit in order to make up for the thing that we don't have the board we want to play on. And yeah, what do we have? We have a backdoor flush draw, but not the front door flush draw. So let's make this, in this case, diamonds and spades. We are betting flop smallish, and that's what I did. So I bet smallish, he raises smallish. And ace jack, what was it, ace nine, apply filters. Looks like we are supposed to move in case we bet get a, we have a backdoor flush draw, at least some of the time, but yeah, other backdoor flush draws, especially if we block a nine, we are not moving in. So let's make it our hand again. So that's this one, and this one is exclusively calling, only losing very tiny bit, at least against GTO ranges. And unfortunately, we cannot continue from here, as there are no turn ranges, right? So if I call, yeah, then that's the end. But I guess that's one of the better cards in the deck, and we got to stick it in. If he's having a flush draw, we might be a huge favorite. Yeah, unfortunately, he had jack seven and I was completely crushed, but I guess nothing I can do about this. By the way, Stars today made me so fucking angry. I was getting coolers and tough spots all the way, and yeah, well, and setups, and it was no fun at all. But the thing which annoyed me the most was that I couldn't open my treasure chest, and I have no clue why that is. I mean, I click it, then this loading button appears, and no matter how long I wait, I never can get a chest, and I never can open it. I closed the software, opened it, and again, same issue. I restarted the computer, same issue. And yeah, this was like so annoying. I mean, I'm another thing that's really annoying is they have this treasure hunt, or however this bullshit is called. So with every chest you open, you also get dice that you can roll, and when if you land on a chest, you can get bonus chests, and this is a playing field of like 50 fields or something. And so far, I only hit one chest, so running very bad, but now it would be unavoidable to hit some chests, because in the end there are like 6 or 7 squares where every one of it has a chest, and now I cannot claim my chest. So that's like, I was like so tilted. And yeah, this happened also in the past, but yeah, I no idea how to fix it. I just came back later and tried again, or reopened the software, and at some point it was working again. But yeah, Stars definitely needs to fix that issue. Let me know if you got this issue as well. Can you sometimes also not open your chests? Yeah. Okay, moving on. I guess this hand was fine, but still, you feel so bad, and feel like a complete idiot when you call and have 5% because he has jack 7. Yeah, moving on. Ah, that's a very tough one, I got to say. Preflop action was he raises, I call, he squeezes, and we both call, and that's our flop. And he checks, he bets full pot, and yeah, I don't know what to do. Very annoying spot. In game I folded, but not sure if that's correct, to be honest. And we of course have no multi-way sims, so we have to try to figure this out another way. So let's give this guy, like, he's a bit loose, right? Is he? Yeah. Let's give this guy 30% and excluding the top 5%. This guy today, I don't know if he was on tilt or if he's playing always like this. I mean, his 3-bet set isn't that big, but he was literally 3-betting me every fucking hand. Yeah, not sure if he was just going after me or if it's just playing style or if he was tilted, but that was very annoying and I was never able to hit something or to destroy him. I was like, come on, give me kings, give me aces, but the poker gods never gave me that. So I think one time I got aces and yeah, I 4-bet and he snap folded. And I actually was very, this was a very good result as my aces were like the most crappy ones possible with no suits and completely disconnected. So yeah, good result to just take down the 3-bet. Okay, the crazy dude has something like 13% 3-bet. My hand is 6 diamond, 9 diamond, 8 clubs, 7 spades. Queen club. Let's first run a sim like this and see how good or bad we are doing. So we are almost even here, as you can see. And if we just take into account the perceived preflop ranges, we should get it in. But we got more infos with which we can work. He is checking, so he is trapping, or he has nothing. I guess that he has nothing is a lot more likely. So let's for now assume that he is most of the time going out of the way. And now let's give this guy a range. So the nut flush draw ships it in, queen with a flush draw ships it in, 10 jack chips it in, these good gut shots with flush draw ship it in, 10 king, sets ship it in. Blockers with a flush draw, bluff, and still have some equity in case we get called. At least I assume that that's the case. Is queen 9 just chipping it in? It might be. Yeah, let's assume that queen 9 and queen 8 also just chips in. 8 9 chips in if it has some more additional equity like a flush draw, or 8 9 10, 10 is also an interesting one. 8, 9, jack, jack. 8, 9, 6, 7, 8, 9. I guess, yeah, he has to ship this one in as well. 8, 9, 10, king. 8, 9, king, jack. So let's see how we are doing against this range. Poorly. And as there is almost double the pot size left, we should fold against the range we gave him. Let's expand the range a bit with some more flush draws. But against flush draws, we are also not doing that well. Okay, king with a flush draw. What is king with a gut shot doing? I guess not shoving. No. What is a queen doing with a gut shot to the nuts? I guess also not shoving. So yeah, let's look into the situation. If we make it a bit looser, yeah. So very good laydown by me, as it seems. No, okay. And we are already finished with the hands. And we can now jump into figuring out what the optimal opening range from the small blind is. Fold, and it's on us. I know that we should open like 30% and also limp some, like 15% or something. But I am not, we are not limping that much. We are raising more and limping only a small percentage of hands. Let's first look through these limps. So we are balancing our limps with some limp raises, I guess, because at the top I only see aces. More aces, more aces, more aces, and I guess these strong kings also go for the limp raise. So is he limping some stuff that is not absolutely nutted? Kings. Ace, I guess this is all limp raises. Ace, queen, jack, 10. Queen, jack, jack. So a lot of very strong stuff. So let's get in some filters. We don't want a pair, and we don't want a pair. Yeah, let's apply this one. Just loading. Did it crash? No. Okay. We are limping a lot of aces with Broadway cards too. Okay. We also have to pay attention to these numbers. And yeah, basically, this should not happen very often. So. Are all numbers in the small blind that screwed? I didn't look into this that closely, but it looks like 4%. What is that? Is there a hand which we are limping 100%? Or is this all just 4%, 6%, 7%? Okay, here are some bigger numbers. Okay, hands like this, ace, king, queen, 8, for example, makes sense because we don't want to face a 3-bet out of position, but it's fine to limp call. Yeah, another example from that category, more or less. So a lot of things where we block our own flush draws, or when we have a hand that's very ugly to play if getting three bet. Ace Jack 6-5 should limp, oh, but only 1%. Okay, forgot about this. Forget about this. Yeah, a lot of Broadway stuff that has not the greatest playability. It's limp calling. I assume, I mean, I guess Ace King Queen 7 is not limp folding. So, some con, although that's also again a very low frequency. Guess this also is the most complicated situation you have pre-flop, mastering the small blind. 9865 is limping sometimes, but I guess most of the time raising just at 3% frequency. Yeah, again, more of this Broadway stuff. King Jack 9-8. It's King 9-8. Maybe we need some more filters. We don't want an ace. We don't want an ace. I guess these are all limp raises. He's double suited. Very connected stuff. But at a very low frequency, this is hard to apply as a human. You don't need to be perfectly balanced. Searching for stuff with higher frequencies than just 4, 5, 6%. 15, 14, yeah, okay. So hands we would, so basically hands that we want to play, but which play terrible out of position against the three bet are often limp calling. So rainbow rundown, okay. Yeah, and all these triple suited stuff is often limp calling. I guess in general it's a good adjustment, an exploitable one, but a good adjustment against people who like to go very hard blind versus blind, meaning that he's first not folding and second three betting a lot to limp a lot of stuff that is having a hard time calling a three bet. And of course you then need to have a balanced range against a guy like this, but he cannot just race relentlessly and put in some strong hands as well, which you are going for the limp race. Percent. Okay. So hands which have three of one suit are seem to be prime candidates for limps. 17. Rainbow hands. Yeah, again. Three of a suit. What is this? Let's go a bit more down. I want to see not only big cards, or is this strategy mainly applied with big cards? Yeah, again, big cards, big cards, big cards. Is this a filter here? I think it's one in Pro Poker Tools, so let's see if it's working here too. B should stand for big, and yeah, remove all the big cards, but yeah, it is not. Because yeah, these are big cards, and I don't understand why the pairs are in there too. Maybe I messed it up, and what should I have messed up? I don't know. We want no pair, and we also want, I hope this is working out, no ace, no king, no queen, no jack. Okay, let's just exclude this stuff. Hope that this is a working filter. Yes, it is. So let's look into some non-Broadway hands which are limping at a bigger frequency than just 2%. 19%. So rundowns, rainbow version of it. Again, stuff which has three of a suit. That seems to be a theme, or four of a suit. I would assume that this hand also raises a lot, because it's not that ugly to call a three bet with this one. Percent. Yeah, that's a one gapper with no suit. Oh, another big one. Okay. Seems like, yeah. Oh, 51. Okay, again a rundown, but no suits at all. These three connected cards and a dangler also sometimes play this way. How long can I go down here? Check 10, 9, 3. Thought this was sorted by big to small cards, but it isn't. I think it's sorted by the EV you got. So soon it has to be over. Okay, small rundowns, all these connected but not very well connected stuff. odd suits or blocking his own suit. Okay. Let's again look into some pairs. Let's say we want a pair, but we don't want an ace, a king, or a queen. Although queens are interesting, so yeah, let's look into this one briefly and then look into the raising range. Okay, these are traps. Okay, a lot of traps. Yeah, double pairs which trap. I guess this is not necessarily a trap, it's just limp call, I suppose. But yeah, I'm not sure. This definitely should be a limp call. Oh, is it? Yeah, I think so. I mean, we don't want to get forward for sure. Let's move down to some weaker ones. Queen, queen, jack, deuce. So, yeah, these hands would also hate to get 3-bet. So, queen, queen. Looks like there are many queens in this. Some jacks too, but only at 1%. So, yeah, can probably ignore that. Another huge chunk of queens, more queens, more queens. Jacks, double pair, but a frequency that can be ignored. Yeah, connected tens, but also at a low frequency. Let's go to the bigger ones again. Queens, tens, check, 10, 10, 5. Is anything here? I didn't saw anything at I think that's the first one at 51%. I mean, every other thing is lower frequency so far. So yeah, these are very bad queens, which we cannot stand the heat if getting 3-bet. Oh, makes sense. Jack, 10, 10, 4, okay. Mm, 55%, okay, another bad queens. Okay, let's move down to some even weaker hands. Look into some of these. Jack, jack, okay. 9, 9. Semi-connected. More queens, jacks, with a lot of gaps, more jacks, nines with some connectivity, jacks, jacks. Ten, ten. Okay. 8, 8, 6, 4. Okay, I think we now got a decent idea what to do with our limbs. Let's now look into the hands we are supposed to raise with. First, with no filters. So all the good stuff raises most of the time. The aces. What about the kings? Most kings raise. Only kings fold that have trips. Is this correct? Looks like it. So all kings are played. And most are played with an raise. Very bad kings are just limp called. Okay. What about queens? I guess a lot of limbs with queens. No, not that many. Still. The very worst ones fold. Most of it are trips. Some call. Some also trap. And yeah, most still raise. What about jacks? The worst ones fold. Again, some limbs with a few traps, but mostly hands that we can't stand the heat from a 3-bet, I guess. And still, most of them are re-raising. Let's move to further down into the pocket pair category. Yeah, tens, now a few more folds, but still most are getting raised. Nines. Yeah, okay, nines. This is a huge threshold here. We see a lot more folds with nines, and I guess this goes up even more if you, yeah, lower the pocket pair. Okay, sevens is not loaded yet. Oh, it is. Okay, let's do fours. Okay, so the weakest pocket pairs seem to fold the majority of the time. Let's now take hands like, yeah, ace king. Do we want another Broadway card? Yeah, jack, ten, or queen, and we want to have no pair in hand. This filter is not working, as I still see a lot of pairs. So let's just make it jack and no pair. This one should work. It is. Seems like this Broadway stuff, if it's not rainbow, still raises a lot. Let's make this last card something very terrible, like a six. No. Limping the worst ones. Trap with, again, with some traps and raising the rest. Let's now get a similar hand, but removing the ace and taking a 10 instead. These stuff also gets raised most of the time. What happens if we make the 6 a 3? Are we getting more folds out of this? Not that much. So, 3 high cards should be played most of the time. Yeah, so. Pocket pairs we already looked into. Let's look into, I think that's what is, how are double suited hands in general be played. We are folding very crappy ones. Most of the time with small cards or small pairs, as it seems. Oh, 6-5-3-2. This is the beauty of a hand. I don't know if I could ever lay that one down. So small cards seem to be hated by the solver. And yeah, double suited still opens the majority of the time. Only the very worst fold. What about single suited hands? With single suited hands, we need to be a lot more picky, as from this category, more than half of the hands get folded. I also wonder, do these numbers add up to 100%? Let's check. Okay, wait, do. I'm just very bad in doing calculations. But math is okay, but no calculations in my head. These don't work. What is the, how do we say rainbow? This definitely is working. So rainbow hands, almost 80% get folded. Okay, I think we are sort of prepared to do a quiz. Yeah, that's, how do we do this? Is this bucket training? What do I need to click here? Reynolds equity buckets. I'm not 100% sure what I need to click in order to start a quiz. Is this a equity chart, board overview, bucket matrix? I guess it's add buckets. What is add buckets? No, we don't want to do that. I want to do a quiz. Chat, help me. How do I do this? Buckets training, equity buckets training. Buckets to filter. Apply ranges? No. Sorted by EV, by percentage, by no. Equity buckets training. No villain data specifies. Okay, what? Do I need to do now? Not from. No. That's not what you want to do. Buckets training. Okay, he's doing something. I hope. Oh, yeah. Okay. Ah, very nice. So we can start now. I say that's a fold. Bam. Next one. Mets a full two. I guess that's a raise most of the time. This is an easy fold. Raise. Yes, raise. I remember that hands of this sort got called some. So let's go with a call. No, that's incorrect. It's a raise. Okay, that's definitely not a raise. That's a fold too. Raise it. Fold. Still raise. Fold. Raise. Raise. Fold. Fold. Raise. Raise. Fold. Strong enough to raise in my world. Also strong enough. Not strong enough. I'll raise it. Seems like I'm have a better intuition of what to do than I expected. Ooh. This one seems a bit tough. No! It's a fold. Okay. Easy raise, easy raise, 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 fold, 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 raise, raise, fold, raise, raise, fold. Fold, I guess. Fold. Fold. Easy fold. Raise. 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 Fold. Bam! 96% correct. I just limped the fucking queens because I remembered it from before, but yeah, actually this was not correct. So yeah, we are experts. Well, and with we, I mean, I'm an expert in this. We could make it more difficult, I guess. A wee between. It's, I hope that's working. So now it should be more difficult, I hope. And how can we restart? Start training. Close. Refresh hands. Start training. Okay, now we have tougher hands in there. That's already a tough one. Still raise? No. That has to be a raise. 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 Fold. Raise, fold, 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 raise, raise, fold, fold. Twitch Chat ist noch herb. Fold. Raise. 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 Fold. 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 Ah, fold. Fold. These are the hands he likes to call a lot. Fold. Fold. Raise, 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 fold, raise, 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 fold, raise, fold, raise, 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 fold, raise. Raise, fold, 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 98%, ship it, okay, we are experts, could do another training, yeah, oh, did I close down the complete thing, nope, what is interesting to us, Chat, you want to suggest something, or do I have to choose? Okay, as I got no feedback in chat, we do the button open next. Bucket training. I hope this was visible for you. I guess. I mean, now it's definitely visible. Okay, let's go. Race. Race. Fold. I think we need to stop here and make this more difficult. Clear. No. Fuck. Or what do we need to do? Whoop whoop and refresh hands. Okay, let's go. Start training. Raise. Fold. Raise. Fold. Oh! I just had in mind that I mean, in game I probably don't never fold, but yeah, so I am correct to be a bit crazy. Raise. Raise. Fold. Ugh. Raise, yeah. Raise, raise, fold. Raise. Race. Seems close to me. Fold. Okay. Fold. Fold. Right. Fold. Raise. Fold. Fold. Oof. Fold. Ooh, these cards are low. Raise. 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 Fold. Raise. Yep. Fold. Fold. Raise. Fold. Raise. Fold. Raise. Raise. Okay. Fold. Raise. Fold. 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 Raise. Fold. Raise. Ooh, no. That's not in there. Raise. Fold. Raise. Fold. Twitch chat, help me. Fold, correct. Race. 96%. Also an expert in button play. Okay, let's do one for. No. Don't want to close the whole thing, we just want to close this, and we want to do this for every position and see where our league's at. Now moving on to the cutoff. Is this loaded already? Yes, it is. Bucket training. You need to make this a lot harder. So let's use one. Let's go with 0.5. Refresh hands. Start training. The first one is already tough. I raise. Wrong. Okay. That's definitely a raise. Nope. Nope. Nope, I guess. Also, nope. Yes. Yes. Nope. Yes. This is fun. Still no help from Twitch chat. Fold? Nope. Oh, but this is very close. Yep. Raise it, raise it. Fold. 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 Raise it. Raise it. Fold. Raise it. Raise it, but whoa, this was very close. Fold. Fold. Raise it. Fold. Raise it. Fold. Fold. Raise. Raise. Raise? Yep. Fold. Not sure. Yes, close. Raise it. No! No raise it with Jack 9 deuce. Okay, no raise it with Jack 9 deuce. I guess no raise it. Yep. Jack 9 deuce was not a raise, so fold. Yeah. Fold. No! So that's a bit surprising. Okay. Are we folding kings from the cutoff? That's a very good question. If we are fold some kings from the cutoff, this is probably in there. Oh, dude. Raise. Yes. Raise. Yes. Raise. Yes. Nope. Eh? We had this one, right? Fold. Was? Oh, it was a 9 instead of a 10. My bad. Fold. Race. Race. Fold. No, 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 no. Fold. Race. Race? No way. Okay. Fold. Fold. Okay, we are worse in the cutoff, but we also made the difficulty a bit higher. And what is the EV loss? Okay, the EV loss is very low, I guess. 0.44, yeah. So cutoff again seems to be okay-ish. Moving on to the middle position. From cloud, back, download. Bucket training. 22, almost 23% we are allowed to raise. So we got to keep this in mind. Make this again a lot more difficult. And refresh hands. Did this work? Not sure. Refresh hands. Hello, hello. Hello, trainer. Refresh hands. Okay. Ah, okay. Now he did it, I guess. Fold. 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 No. Okay, but tiny mistake. Fold. Fold. Again, a tiny mistake. Fold. Fold. Raise. Fold. Raise. Yeah, I guess these ace kinking stuff is good. Fold. Raise. Not sure. I go with fold. Raise. Fold. Fold. King I suit. That's interesting. Ugh. Raise? Whoa! Very close one, but still a raise. Fold. Fold, Fold, Raise, Fold, Raise, Raise. This can be a fold. In game, I would raise, but can this be a fold? Yes, no, no fold. Sorry, that's a fold. Raise, fold. I like raise, but that's a tiny mistake. Raise, raise. This is right. Okay, fold. Right? No, but made a mini mistake. Raise? No. Raise? Yes. Nope. Nope. Nope, I guess? No, it's a small expectation when raised. Raise? 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 Nope. What's it's a close one. It's not so close. Raise. Raise. Yep. Raise. Raise. Fold. Wow. Raise it. 86. I think we got 86 for the cutoff too. So yeah. Let's move on to early position. And again, chat, feel free to also help me in the tough situations. So we are now training the open race, open raising range from the first position. Bucket training. And of course, we will only look into very difficult hands. So we click this, gone. Make this only 0.5. Click refresh hands. And here we go. That's easy. Fold. Chat? Any ideas? Fold? Okay. Fold. Raise it. Raise it. Fold. King's getting folded. Raise. Kings. Are these kings a fold too? Close. I say raise. Okay. Fold easy. Raise easy. Raise easy. This one is tough. Fold, I guess. And it's correct. And this is a race. This is an easy race. Another race. More races. Fold. Race. Race. Fold, raise, Fold. Fold, I guess. No? Ooh, that's surprising. This hand looks very bad to me. But it seems like it has a good EV when opened. Raise and fold and fold and fold. Fold. This might be a raise. It is raise. Fold. Ui. Ui, ui, ui. I say fold. Correct. Hi. fold. 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 No. Oh, that's a bigger mistake. Raise. Fold. Easy. That's not that easy. Hi, Kevin Nido. Fold here. Could be a raise. Okay, nope. Oh, that's opening trash like this is very expensive. So yeah, this needs a lot more connectivity, I guess. Is this enough connectivity? I say yes. 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 No. Yes. Yes. No. 94%. 5-5-3-4 double suited. Okay. Even if you expect multi-way port, I guess to this should be the answer. No, I. But yeah. In game, I would probably never lay this hand down. Let's see. But it's an open. You are correct about this. What do you think? Are you opening it if you expect multi-way pots? I guess if you expect multi-way pots, you probably need to make adjustments like not opening as many small pairs, because you will often be dominated, and you probably also need higher rundowns because you don't want to be on the idiot end of a straight draw of a straight. Yeah, as you can hear, there's some background noise, and unfortunately I have to go. I hope you enjoyed this session. Yeah. If you did, please make sure to follow and also check out my YouTube. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.